So before, we have more than 40 camps along the border here, from Myanmar to Kanchanaburi, along the border. And you know this, we have many NGOs, friends who are concerned for us, came and helped, they help us. So we are really grateful to God, and we thank all the NGOs and all friends who have been faithfully supporting us. No? But the struggle is very, very difficult. When we came here, we became a refugee. Now, we came here, 1990 is a year when the Burma declared herself to be free, and they have election. They says now opposition leaders, Aung San Suu Kyi was released from prison, and now they have formed a party, the NLD, and they're going to have an election, and NLD already registered, and now they are in the they compete in the election. So the election 1990, but on the other hand, when there this is peaceful, inside everything is nothing happened, no problem, but along the border there were a lot of fighting. You can hear from here, you can hear the shooting, the gun, with big mortars and all things from the other side, everywhere. So it happened like that. So what happened was that we have to come to this camp. When we came here in 1990, even the Thai authority, UNHCR, all they thought it would be only a matter of few months or few years, because there was election already held and NLD won election, and if the NLD become the have the opportunity to run the country as form the government, then there was, because Aung San Suu Kyi and all the leaders, the NLD, they promised that if independent came to Burma, the NLD won election, the first thing they will do is for national reconciliation. They will try to have it. So we thought that it will be, the NLD will be faithful to their promise, and they will fulfill their promise. And so we are very, very much positive for the returning home. But all of a sudden, as to all the surprise of the whole world, the Burmese, the junta, refused to honor the result of the election that they hold. They says election is free and fair and just. But when Aung San Suu Kyi and LD won election, they don't give the power to them. So that we have to live in the camp. And we don't know how many years we will live. But we live now. So Thailand also, they call us only displaced people. It means that we come here just to take refuge, temporary refuge. In front of the camp, you will see this is Mela temporary shelter. Temporary is 24 years already. I mean, don't know how many years, but and now, when they have the ceasefire agreement, there's a big mistake or misunderstanding of the many of the friends and also the U.S. and even the EU and all those world leaders. They were thinking that forcing that there will be changes in Burma because of the new government, because of the ceasefire agreement. They said that this is the assumption that they made, that we came here, we Ukrainian refugees, we came to the camp because of the fighting. Now there's no fighting, we can go home. But that is impossible for us. We cannot go home because, even though there's a ceasefire agreement, you see, different armed groups still have arms in their hands. So they can start fighting anytime, like Kachin State. After 17 years of ceasefire, they start fighting, and many Kachin people become refugees. And now they have a lot of people suffering. So it is very difficult. And at the same time, there were a lot of landmines planted. And also our places where we come from, we cannot go back because it's already occupied by the Burmese, the soldiers. Some places they have a big company. So how can we go back? We have no place to go back. Personally, this is my personal conviction, and I try to encourage all the leaders, even all the teachers, We are all volunteers, even in the school and also in our Bible college here. We are all volunteers. We don't have salaries. And we don't look for salaries where we can work. Our main objective of our purpose is just to get our young people to get opportunity where they can get as possible as possible to do the highest education. So we try the best we can do, because we don't want them to roll around as aimlessly because they live in the barbed wire. We don't want them to roll around aimlessly, feeling depressed or just get involved in dirty business like drugs and all HIV, AIDS, things like that. So we try the best we can to create an opportunity where they can study. And our purpose is just study and just prepare for the future. Yeah, we are hoping that one day there'll be a time for us where we can go home. Mm-hmm. But the problem is, we want to go home as a human being, created in God's own image. We want to go home with dignity and with freedom, enjoying our right and freedom as a people, not as a refugee again, not as a living in the camp in Burma again. So this is what we want. And we want security. So without security guarantee for us, then it's difficult for us to go back. What I want to say is this. Because of the assumption that the Khmer people are they come to Thailand because of the civil war, because of fighting. They have to come to the camp and they have to live in Thailand. Now because there's a ceasefire, there's no fighting, so they can go home. No need to help the Khmer people, no need to help the refugees. So even the supply of the refugees, the camp, reduced. No guarantee for security, no guarantee for the everlasting ceasefire. Because different groups, they have guns in their hand. They can start fighting anytime. And also, it's very difficult for us to go back because we have no place to go back. One thing very possible is now Japanese government have the Burmese government a lot of money. Now with this money, the Burmese the government or the military or wherever they can do many things. They are building the offices, the clinic, the school, and building the places where the refugees can go back. But for us, we feel very unsafe. It's not safe for us to go back and live in the camp. We don't want to live in the camp. If we go home, we want to go to our own places where we can live as a people with our own dignity, as a people, with enjoying our freedom, our rights, and rebuild our life. We don't want to go back as a changing camp. Our camp in Thailand changed into a camp in Burma. Just under the military or under the present the junta or the government, or even the government, you see, even though they call it a civilian government, it's still controlled by the military. And many of the government officers are all the ex-military generals. And so for very difficult for us to go back. So I want to tell all the people, friends in the West, just to think carefully about the plight of our people. Just look for the business, look for opportunity for doing business, doing something that will be very unfair to our people. So we want to request for them to consider to help us.